Here's the pitch right side. Alfonso James trying to get a nice block to the 45. Stop and go move to the 40. 35. Doing it. Field short drop, quick slant, picked off! Here's Will Barnes to the 50, 45, 40, 35, 30. He looks to make a move. Experience,
it,
I think.
It really is. You know, a team that has come so far, and they don't know how far they can come, and they're going to be wearing some special mementos, as we mentioned, befitting of this conference championship, the league championship, actually, in the first ever playoffs. And I tell you what, you look down the road, Art Mandelbaum, 3, 4, 5 years, there's just no telling how far this program can go.
left, including Dixon. He looks left, dances,
and hit and sacked. Almost three is picked up, and here come the Cougars the other way. Is it Blaine Kurtz?
Yes,
it is. He will score.
From the middle, as far as he can, and looks on the ball.
Intercepted! The Cougars, Chancey Donald's got it. That's the ball game.
That's Jackway coming in motion, and they counter run, and there is a nice run by Sturber. He's in the clear inside the 30-yard line to the 20. They finally catch up to him around the 15-yard line. And Lito with the pitch. He's got the first down on the way inside the 20. Still on his feet inside the 10, 5. Touchdown if he stays inside. And Andy Papagiannis says he's ready for the snap. Waiting for it. Here it is. Put down. Kick is on the way. It's low, and it is blocked, and it's picked up. And here is a run by Andy Papagiannis into the end zone for a touchdown. Do you believe? What a comeback. The Cougars win it in electrifying, stupefying fashion. Right, and Garen Stokes, short drop, looks and hits, fighting the ball is free, and it'll be picked up by Van Horn. Van Horn individually sacking Garen Stokes, and looking back to the left, throws it over the middle, looking for Cease. Cease has got a step. He's got the catch inside the 35, inside the 30, to the 27. There's your big play. Home, and that's a pick, and it'll be an interception. It'll be a safety, so it'll come out into that pole cover again. Game right here. Goal line offense is in. Smith hands it off. Rohrbaugh spun around. Did he get there? Let's see. And he is short. The Cougars have held, and they continue.
Van Horn, and off to the races. Zach Rainey will take it in for the touchdown. 18 out of 22 this afternoon. Double pumps, won't get it away. Marty starts blitzing, makes the tackle. Fake to Thomas. McCutcheon, and that ball's picked off by Ellington. Across the 10, spun down at the 12.
6'5", 230 pounds, and he can throw the football. He has thrown for over 7,000 career yards with 65 touchdowns. Now, these two guys are guys that I feel we will soon see playing on Sundays in the NFL.
Four different running backs for St. Francis. You never know which angle they're coming from, which way they're going to be running, and that's what makes their offense so difficult to stop. Still looking, plenty of time, and he's got a lot of room over there, and he may have enough for the first down. Quarter. Oh, what a shot! What a shot! The pass intended out there.
These guys can do. These corners are quick, and they will come up with between the corners and the safeties, and they will hit guys. That is a very aggressive tackle.
It's times like these you give again.
Setting up this guy to let him come in, Lito, and then break back in a hole. What a big hole that is. Nice cutback running by Lito.
To the 20, oh, he is just horse calling out of there. Very hard tackle by St. Francis to keep this drive going. Jack, oh, and what a great play. Chris Bramble, all kinds of room. Jen Thomas, oh, what a shot. What a shot he takes, just jolting him. Shotgun yet again. He's got a man out there. And again, it's Bumgarner. Oh, what a shot! Oh, my goodness! He is just absolutely bombed by Kurt again, but hangs on to the ball this time.
This is that wide receiver screen that we talked about earlier. They made yards on it on a couple of plays, but after that, watch this hit.
And listen to this.
And that.
the game, and what a start for St. Francis. Daniel Carter, all kinds of speed, and he gets all the way to the outside, and he breaks it open on the far sideline. He gets it inside the 30, down to the 25. Motion hooks, keeps it. He's got a man coming out of the backfield and into the end zone for a touchdown.
Across a young man's room, she said, I'm ready for you. Why? I can't remember anything.
The big Tim Farrell on a big sack of Chad Cavender.
Except the love. The love.
Cavender now back to pass. He's going to be wrestled down from behind. Cavender. And he's going to be intercepted and taken back the other way. And this one may go to the house. And going to be knocked down inside the 20.
There's that big play momentum that we talked about. Watch it get batted up right there by Jarrell Hunter. And then you see Farrell pick it up right there, take it. I thought he was gone. We see a nice job here by the St. Francis defense containing Cavender.
Thank you.
to the five, cuts it up, and he will score. Nice run that time. Antoine Campbell, remember, a field goal would win it in a one-point lead for St. Francis. Here's a cut to the right. And it's going to be St. Francis has got the ball inside the 40 and down to the 36-yard line, as coming up with that loose football is going to be Devin. Now throws over the middle. He's got a man wide open. Touchdown. Austin Coleman and Bosa set that one up beautifully. Steps up, throws, and that tip ball intercepted. And it'll be Richardson here to keep ball on the near side. And he's all the way inside the 25 to the 20. If it stands up, he'll have a touchdown. Outside the 20, runs to the right, cuts to the 25, 30. Trying to nice move back to the middle of the field to the 40, 45, 50. He's got a chance. He's got blockers in front inside the 30. Screens the ball right side, running room. Here's Campbell, gets by one. He's got the first down. He's got a chance to score. He'll go inside the 10. And Coleman tracking it into the end zone, 2 yards deep. He'll bring it out to the 5. 10-yard line, right side, 15, 20. Down the sideline, still on his feet. Cuts back to the 30, 35. Gets by another. Still on his feet with a blocker up ahead. 40, 45, 50. Midfield directing traffic at the 39. Reverses, gets by another man. Cuts it up, spins off a tackle. Back inside the 30. Works out to the 5, works 10-yard line, 15. Trying to cut back, he's across the 25, 30. To the right side, one man to beat. At the 50, 40. They're not going to catch him. Needs a block as Campbell turns the corner. 40, 45, 50. He's got a chance. He's in a foot race inside the 20, inside the 10. 41-41 tie. Waiting for the snap. The hold's got to be good. The kick is long enough on the way and good. And turns the corner at the 40, 45, and St. Francis Anthony Moore in a diving without a tackle, without a helmet. Anthony Moore lost his helmet back to the 48, no problem.
Interfered with because the defender was literally on his back. He reached out and jumped and tipped the ball up.
No, it's a play action fake and Bosa over the middle. He's got Coleman and he's got it at the 40, at the 30. He will go into the end zone. Here we go as the kick will come down. St. Francis has got it with a return inside the 20 and picking his way, and a return some open fields across the 20, and that's going to be Coleman on his way for a touchdown.
Pressure on again and throwing away. Tip ball. Oh. Intercepted. And Brody Kelball with a chance inside the 15 to the 10 and a touchdown.
Football 365 around here.
You shouldn't be satisfied, with your bucket half.
We had a chance really to bond with some guys.
We overcame, the adversity and we found a way to win.
There's an expectation here to win every game, no matter who you're playing.
They will not get the first down. The ball may have popped.
Yoder wants to throw. Rush is coming. Throws. He's got a man. There's a catch for a touchdown. Option run, and he spun around and dropped as Moose came shooting through there from his defensive end position.
Hands the ball off. Here's Campbell. Quick move up the middle. Tripped up. He had a chance.
Here's Hunsucker into the game and completes. And there's a run by Coleman to the 40, 30, 45, 50. Down the right sideline. He's got a chance inside the 20, 15, 10, 5, and a touchdown.
Had a couple of attempts. Here's Freeman looks to the right side. And now he's got a interception by Stamps. Down the left sidelines. He's got a chance to score and into the end zone.
For me, I look at the list of guys that's won that award, and I know those guys, and I know how hard they work, and I know how much this program and this university has meant to those guys, and you're just honored to have that award and be in that class with those people. That award, that plaque, has been on, I don't have many things on my wall. Maybe that's my wife doesn't let me put them up, or I just don't put many things up. But one thing I've always had up is that award for the Silver Helmet, and it's meant a ton to me. And it's to be in that class with those guys is awesome. One of the biggest things we do here, and I say we, I still consider myself part of this program, and we do here is we work hard, and we work hard year round. And guys are committed to working hard in the weight room. They're committed to what the plan is. And when coach puts something before them, and I think this was back in 1998 when we started this thing and we got here, there was a bunch of guys that just wanted to work hard, were hungry to win. And that's how we set the tempo of what it is. And in the offseason, you look at the offseason program and how it's evolved into what they do today. And that was a huge part of us going from two wins to eight wins.
Shouldn't be satisfied, with your bucket half full. And every day you've got to work to get that bucket up to where it's overflowing, where you're reaching your full potential. Because potential doesn't mean anything if you don't reach what you can be. If you've got the potential to be the best, but you're always underachieving, that potential doesn't mean anything then. So you've got to get your bucket filled to the top. And then you'll hit that potential that, coach sees in you, and you can put it in effect on the field. And then, like I said, you take it with you much past your playing days as well, and no matter what it is.
It is an honor to be upon a wall with such great athletes, such great players, and such great men of character. In order to be the best, you want to compete at your best. Without having someone that is going to compete with you on a daily basis, you don't have that drive factor to want to elevate your game. There was a number of times that, I had Elijah Flowers, Donovan Evans, Jarrell Hunter, we all in the weight room competing, with weights, on the football field competing with 40s and talking trash, talking back and forth. And those that was something that drove you to want to get better, that drove you to want to be the best person out there. So I definitely think that's just a part of being in a competitive sport, and that's something that naturally is going to drive you in order to for you to reach your peak. It's the number one thing that you have to do to be successful is be consistent and stay focused. If you keep your priorities straight, you're going to be fine. The coaches are going to put you in a path to success. Make sure you don't deviate from that path. Go Cougars.
To Kelsall, believe it is, at the 20-yard line, and gets some running room up the middle as it brings across the 30 to the 35. That's Coleman. Austin Coleman, near side, 40-45. Leaps over a tackler in the foot race. He's got a chance inside the 20, inside the 10, the 5, and a touchdown, Austin Coleman. And he's got the snap. He looks to throw. Steps up in the pocket. Throws the home run ball. He's got a man. There's Knight. And did he hold on? He's got the ball.
I think it was just we put a lot of pressure on ourselves. And honestly, we expected to win. You know, there wasn't a doubt in our mind each and every game that we went into that we were going to lose. You know, out of the 4 years that I played here, we didn't lose a single game here at home. You know, there's even a game against St. Ambrose where we were, kicking in a field goal to win it, and it was a bad snap. You know, Andy Papagiannis picked it up, you know, and swept around to the corner of the end zone to score. And, you know, that was the probably the closest time that we came to losing a game on this field. But, you know, we overcame, you know, the adversity and, you know, we found a way to win. And that's what we did so many times, you know, was kind of that relentless, you know, feeling and drive that we had to go out each and every Saturday, whether it be on our home turf or someone else's. We were going to take it, own it, and come away with a win.
We came in my freshman year, and everyone wanted to be on the field. I expected to play my freshman year. You know, I was lucky enough to do that. Coach Donley's not afraid to play freshmen. So if you come in and want to take a lackluster approach to the game, then we kind of say, you know, turds flush themselves. You know, we don't have to worry about kicking people off the team. I mean, you kick yourself off the team because everyone plays at this level. If you don't want to play at that level, you're not going to play with that work ethic and excitement and wanting to be on the squad. That's fine. You can go. You know, you have to go out there and find the right players that fit into your mold and what you want. And he wants speed, enthusiasm, and aggressiveness. He's consistent in that process. So every year, it's more like the cliche that he's reloading his offense. You know, he is able to mold it somewhat to the players that he has, and he's willing to make some changes. But at the same time, you know, he wants to get out there. He wants to run and gun. He wants fast paced. You know, and defensively, he wants. Sure, he wants shutouts, but he wants nastiness. He wants people to fear his defense, to hear his defense. And, you know, I think that's why we got along so well, because you know, I wasn't necessarily always the best listener, but he knew that I was going to go out there and I was going to play 110% no matter what.
Cut up the middle. They mark it down at the 8. Campbell again. Now trying to run to the left and into the end zone. Antoine Campbell. The penalty flags are thrown. He'll throw the ball as long as he can. He's got Cam Smith. He's got the catch at the 40. And the give is to Campbell. Campbell cuts to his left, working to cut inside the 30 to the 25, spins down to the 20-yard line. Well, the running call they do, and he runs right side. Second effort, did he score? He did. Campbell for the third time tonight.
The offensive line played great. The receivers blocked well, and the coaches gave me the opportunity.
Looks and he'll hand it off, and that's going nowhere. Matt Carton read that play and got through there. Here's Parsons pulling the ball down, spun around, and they had him for a moment, and they do. Carton's got him wrapped up in second. And here's Fulton wanting to throw, being pressured and dropped. And the ball is free. It'll be picked up and out, and they rule it down. The whistle blew by the referee. It was a free ball. Stretch handoff again, looks right side, and second effort, driving for the goal line, touchdown. Will they run? They will, with Campbell. Cuts to his left, gets into the second level. He's got a chance to score, and he will. Antoine Campbell, they've got a catch by Campbell, and they go into the end zone. Miller to throw again, looks right, waits, now runs, and throws the ball up, and that is caught at the 40-yard line. That was a kind of a shovel pass. Woods and Dustin Underwood are the tackles. Here's a run up the middle, and here's some daylight for Nicodemus. down the middle, and that one's picked off.
It was tough, man. This is what we practice all week for. Situations like this is when we play the game for. It was fun. It came down the right way we wanted.
There's a ball up, and that one's picked off at the goal line.
Fuller loads up, throws over the middle. He's got a catch. The 45, to the 40. That's Cam Smith. Tripped up, but now he's going to reach his inside. The 30 is going down.
Pulls it down, throws back to the left. Got a crossing pattern catch. Seth Coates behind the defense to midfield. He's at the 40 in a foot race. Inside the 20, to the 15, to the 10, and a touchdown. Seth Coates once again, 83 yards on the touchdown.
it off on the screen. Justin Green's got it. Cuts to the 20, 25, middle of the field. Gets away from another one. And they'll run the ball off to the Rangers. Justin Green finds a bit of a hole. He's behind the defense. He's all the way to midfield and finally hauled down from behind. To the right, now comes back to the left side, looking to the left corner, and there's a fingertip catch. Good, Coates got it in the left corner of the end zone. He had double coverage, but he beat them both for the far end of the throw. Looks, throws vertical, looking downfield. He's got a man. There's Coates with a fingertip catch inside the 10 and brought down. Drops the throw, steps up, and is going to be sacked, wrapped up, and dropped back outside the 40-yard line. Cougars came through there. Christian Johnson was there, and Pearson Harnish as well.
A big bull rush.
Heavy snow isn't going to keep this receiver from two spectacular touchdown catches. Watch University of St. Francis wide receiver Seth Cote catch this ball. He bobbles it, but somehow recovers to score the TD. But if that wasn't enough, he does it again. This time he tips it to himself while a defender is all over him and stays in bounds to score. Seth helped his team get a playoff win and looked really cool doing it.
That's the type of in-game adjustments you need to be able to make, especially for us. You know, it's no secret we're going to get everybody's best, and it's just part of playing at St. Francis.
Took 11 guys on defense to do their own individual job.
Well, they talked about this is a sleeping giant. We just needed to wake up.
Eyes on one goal, and that's the national championship, so we want to come out and prove it.
I'm glad we came out on top.
Me too.
Lawton pulls it down, and he's going to pay the price. Ball pop free, but Owen Yu is going to cough it up one way or the other. That time as he ran into Hellegarn, among others, back around the 18 or 19. Set up about 3-4 yards deep in the end zone. They'll hand the ball to him, looking for running room, off tackle. Brings it out across, and he's in down the left sideline, across the 30, 40 at midfield. Inside the 35, they'll not catch him today. Justin Green to the house. He'll run for 89 yards and a touchdown at the 8:34 mark. Justin Green looked like he was bottled up right about the 10-yard line. I was looking down to write the score down.
Let's go, boys.
It's a playoff rematch from 2012 between these two football teams with the national championship on the line here tonight. Baker comes in to Florida with a perfect 14-0 record, number two in the NAIA. And Ferrer looking for Coach, throws the fade up. Looking. He's got the ball for a touchdown for Bertel, the NAIA All-American. And being pressured, and they've got him very down inside the 46-yard line for a Cougar sack. Sparks again, the Hellegarn. Backfield looking, dances, throws right side. He's got a catch, but the Cougars are there. And it'll be a loss back around the USF 49-yard line.
Clark paid the ultimate price that time, guys.
Here's motion by Boswell, and here's Green up the middle into the second level. Breaks to his left. He's got the defense.
Oh, he got a catch.
Green to the house for 39 yards. The Cougars on the board on the last play by Justin Green. Spin play. Ferrer steps up, throws left side.
Oh, he's
Coates light open. He's got the ball to 15 to the 10. Radar's one. He's got a touchdown. That one is good for 59 39 yards at the 44-second mark. How did Seth Coates get that wide open?
Unbelievable. How do you lose a guy like Seth Coates behind you of all places?
Yard, money. Coates down to the end zone with his third catch of the night for a touchdown.
I just had a feeling Coates lined up as a tight end that time on the right.
38-17, Cougars win it. The national championship in 2016 by 21 big points.
You know, it starts back to 1997 with that first class. I'm fortunate enough to see it from the very, very beginning. And there's a lot of people that contributed to this. I know it was a long time ago. The foundation was laid and continued to build over these many years. And this is the culmination. This is what we waited for. It's what we worked hard for. And so many have.
It's just more than a game. You know, we've been building for this moment for 19 years. The Cougar family that's out there supported us tremendously, and they were here tonight in force. We had some falls, you know, back in the old days where we didn't quite come through for everyone, but we came through tonight.